Yeah, Smart Wargames here. Let's check out Close Combat, The Longest Day. Give me a moment to get into my chat. Sound check.
Sound check.
Yeah, and as far as I know, you know, the Close Combat series and their releases are quite convoluted. I think Close Combat The Longest Day is a remaster of Close Combat Normandy. But it could be that I'm wrong. Here is a manual. Can showcase it you. Stop the video if you're interested to take a look at it. Extensive information. And I've already noticed this has the same, yeah, if you want to say, call it issue, like Close Combat Arnhem, that if you put a game into a low resolution, it will stay windowed. I prefer to play Close Combat in 1600 by 900 without any DPI or any scaling. It offers me the best middle solution between seeing those fantastic sprite arts and having a good interface to work with. So you might want to lower the resolution of your windows to this, to your preference, and then it should go full screen. Yeah, before we go into the game, let's check out the mod database here. And let's see, Close Combat, The Longest Day, here. See if there are some interesting mods for it. I could also imagine that mods for Close Combat Normandy are also working for it, but I can't give you insurance for it. There are definitely a lot of mods here to be found. There's not a lot of descriptions, but you can tell by the name where this might be. Yeah, Africa Classic mod, not sure what this is. CC4 Classic. So there's definitely some options. Kharkov, looks like you can also go Eastern Front with this. Stalingrad Winter War, I guess I mean a Finnish Soviet Winter War. So might be a good option if you look for mods. It looks like from the modern releases, this comes with some good mods. Okay, manual checked. Let's go into the game. It still has a frame because I need to remove this setting and then restart. Now we are full screen. This is perfect. Yeah, usually you have the boot camp. If you're new to the series, scenario creator, multiplayer, you might play local or online. And the game itself, I need to lower the sound of it, otherwise it is hard to talk. Yeah, not sure if there are new battles added. I didn't memorize everything from the classic one, but that's your selection. You can pause the video. Can I? Nah, if I press on it, you are immediately in the battle screen. A lot of historical battles, I guess. Operations. As usual, I will talk about this afterwards. And campaign. I guess that is the operational campaign. Pinnacle of this, and there are limited campaigns, but you can also play the grand campaign either from German or from Ali's side. Let's pick this time the Germans, and yeah, I like to play with time limits, and yeah, it comes to this operation campaign. which indeed looks a bit, but I can't tell really for sure. You definitely this vision is quite slow. You want to use a minimap for movement by holding the mouse. It looks a bit more high res than what I remember from Normandy. I know I streamed it today, but still, you know, it is controversial. It's Close Combat is notorious for its re-releases that might be a good option for new players who perhaps look for a higher resolution or whatever. But somebody that is already owning Normandy, he might think, okay, for this money I need to bring to the table, there's not much to see. Yeah. And that's true, especially now, if you consider that many of those classic Close Combats got released on GOG, and it seems GOG modified them to run on modern systems. Not sure if the original versions also run on modern systems. And some of them are even modified for high resolutions. The difference might get even more marginal. Whatever, we will showcase it and decide for yourself. So need to give a verdict. But they look quite similar. However, I can't remember if this campaign map was like in Normandy. It looks different. Yeah, check the videos. Could be that the operational campaign is completely different. I think in the Normandy one it was another map. So could be that the operational situation in the campaign is different from the Normandy one. Perhaps it is not a one-to-one remaster and they did some further things to it. Because I can't remember seeing this beach setup. Yeah. Okay, as usual, you have formations on the map. And they might be already in contact with enemy forces, as these are. You can click on those formations. We'll get an overlook if you click wherever you mouse button here. You will get a detailed overlook over the formation. What those platoons consist of, with detailed statistics for every individual. That is a big pro for the series, that it is modeling soldiers on an individual level, not abstracting them as being some cannon fodder, despite that everything in Close Combat dies extremely fast. You still have some great elements here. Even a AT gun crew has its supplement of crew. Everybody here, this guy, this is the classic of the series. You can, by pressing on those icons, you can execute the sounds of every weapon. Louder, assistant, etc. Perhaps, unfortunately, you can't rename every single soldier. I would like to have my own name, so the name, my own name or the name of the audience in this. But you can rename units on the squad level. So, yeah. Let's see, is there even a unit free to movement? Those guys. Are we not in a movement phase? Ah, no, they are in contact with enemy. Okay, everybody's in contact with enemy, so execute. You have support elements, currently there's nothing. And battles will about to start. First battle will start here at nearby Utah Beach. And then it will be presented with a screen where you can choose the battle loadout. The battle loadout doesn't include everything of the formation, but you have a force pool where you can select for your own if you don't want to bring two packs. We are German forces. You can remove a pack and instead bring a infantry gun. But if this infantry gun gets destroyed, it is lost. If you don't receive replacements, it is lost. And here you can rename soldiers, or not soldiers, but squads. For example, Zugtrupp is, I think, platoon leader. Normally it would be named Zugführer. Zugtrupp is simply a formation. Because they didn't figure out the translation. But you, yeah, command infantry, you could rename it to yourself or whatever and see if you survive the war. But it's fine. Zugtrupp is fine because it consists more of more soldiers. You can use it like this. It is not force. The Zugtrupp. Yeah, you can name it like this. It's completely fine. So it's not only the leader, the platoon leader, but also coming with the staff of the platoon, like a second in command, etc. Yeah, and we don't have any tanks to showcase, right? You again have two platoons for free selection and one support for free selection. And then you go next, the battle will commence. Let's check out the third free division. I want a chill squad. Yeah, for example, we could do a chill squad, a smart wargame squad and whatever for streaming purposes. Yeah, and you see current... I must say this game models quite well on high resolution. This might be also true for other games. It looks like there's an option that also makes the sprites bigger. To me it appears that even infantry is bigger. Yeah, I'm currently playing with this high DPE option. It might be preferable for many people, especially with eyesight, limited eyesight. But again, you can also lower the resolution. I find a sweet spot being playing at 1600 by 900 or whatever the resolution is, and with normal interface. Because I like to take... Because this game might be one of the most beautiful sprite games, especially in wargaming. Yeah, you guys, I don't know, situate yourself here, that is the infantry gun. You see all details about those guys and what fashion they are. This game is similar design like Combat Mission, focusing on psychological aspects and everything. Yeah, I won't do a serious playthrough, I just want to showcase the gameplay. That is a pack. The pack we might situate here at this road. Wait, that is, yeah, the US will come from here. So indirect fashion, focusing on this road, here somewhere, even here, that looks like a good position. Yeah, the only thing that in this series is a bit clumsy is the facing. It might be that there are hotkeys for better, usually I press on this and change the facing. You need to press on this half circle here. That's a bit clumsy. Everything else is absolutely, even from a modern perspective, I don't do those videos because of nostalgia or whatever. I always analyze those games from a modern perspective, and yeah, look at this. It's amazing. Quite. Yeah, there's a Panzerschreck. I really like this screen because it gives you information. You have to set the flags, which is even easier. Grenadier to the front. Zugtrupp, which is basically the platoon. Yeah, leadership and platoon staff, stay back, Panzerschreck. This is covered by a 7, but we might expect perhaps here and then put them into hide or ambush. Then they will only engage from close range. Machine gun, this building. And everybody else can go defend. You can use this selection and then press and defend, and they will engage immediately. Those guys, there's a mortar here. The mortar we might keep here behind the buildings. Grenadiere. Because we need to protect the flank, but we can do this with a machine gun. I think he's in a head chest, that's fine, but I think I like the building more. I said I like the building more. Yeah, especially this opening here. And Zugtrupp, a second one. Yeah, you are in command of this group here. Grenadiere, occupy this building here. Be ready for flank attacks. Left flank is a bit exposed, but we have some grenadiers here quite at front line. I might rather put them in behind the hatches or even in this building here. That should cover all those. This area here. Could also put them into ambush. And perhaps the US will be triggered to move along here. If I would be US player, yeah, those Grenadier are way too wide forward. And I see I'm tackling packs and everything. What would I do? I would advance through here. Probably, that is obvious option. This is quite dangerous. Or here. And yeah, Grenadier there with some machine gun. Could put them here. Or here in order to strengthen the center. Yeah, sometimes they want to stay somewhere, not sure why. Ah, okay, they hit the hatches. I'm happy. Didn't see it. And then you just press begin. It is dark, it seems, which will limit visibility. Let's get some battle sounds. Yeah, ambush setting might be better here. As you see, they're engaged at maximum distance and their US is responding by mortars, which is not really good because we already lost an assistant of the mortar team. Mortars are extremely dangerous in this game. Or they are absolutely ace. Mortars, sometimes CC is really a game about indirect fire. You can kill millions of people with indirect fire. The only limitation is your ammo. Look at those guys, they are sitting behind a building. I target this spot, see how long it takes for them to get fire down, and they're already firing. And look at this, that is precise fire like nothing. Those guys have no real LOS, but it's rather godlike. I'm looking for a mod that perhaps takes somewhat the emphasis off indirect fire. It is all games, even the most new game is extremely. Indirect fire is absolutely lethal and a bit too precise, especially without LOS. But that's how it is, yeah. You see those guys here hitting. I know it for multiplayer games, there's even limitations how much indirect fire you can bring because, yeah, look at this. That's absolutely nuts. Those guys are. Even the modern mortars can't achieve something like this. Those guys are like Terminator. But you don't want to watch your ammunition. The heck? What the hell? Where are those guys coming? Yeah, that's a surprise, US. Wait, okay, we were surrounded. I didn't realize the tactical situation, but it looks like we are surrounded. Is there a flag that tells me this? Ah, here. Take a look at those flags. It is a US flag, will also tell you from where the enemy can come. Yeah, not bad. I didn't realize there's close combat happening. Zugtrupp, let's see, can we bring some here? You hear people punching each other. That is usually a sign of. I'm also Zugtruppführer. Zugtruppführer, come on. Go to the building, but fast paced. Those guys need assistance. I wasn't aware that we were being attacked from the rear. So always pay attention where the flags are situated. They will tell you. Machine gun stick here, but Grenadier, they come to the south. A new situation developed. But the controls are really one of, I think, in the tactical games, one of the best controls. You can really, especially in this screen, love the screen. You can get, you complete AOB quickly, moving, especially with this pull out order, which defaults to the normal move order. You see enemies, you can quickly lay down, fire here, zack. Not sure if you can lie down fire like this. Is there a modify button? No. It's always move, right? Ah, what is this? Ah, that's a LOS check. Yeah, discovered this for myself. Alt and pulling out is LOS check. Okay, learn something new. So there's a modify button for firing. Ah, that's movement. Movement. Whatever. You can do it. Quickly. Very good controls for a war game of this. Looks like we're seeing some long range fire. Mortars are raining down. Let's hold fire. Smoke is also important in this game. Ah, Lieutenant, okay. In German they say Feldwebel. In English they say Lieutenant, okay. Now I mean, a seasoned Feldwebel might be worth a Lieutenant. Boss, Feldwebel, also took platoon lead, what usually a lieutenant might do. Platoon leaders are usually lieutenants. Company leaders are usually captains or Hauptmann. But indeed, Feldwebel also took platoon command. Yeah, looks good for us. I like the sound. That is really the classic sound. This boop. Yeah, the buildings are quite detailed. You can even move units inside of the buildings. Usually not required that much, but I sometimes like to move them to the facing that. Yeah, those US soldiers gave up. They have. Oh, is it our guys? No. It would make sense that it's our guys. But it can make sometimes sense to micromanage them through the buildings. And yeah, you can, of course, but I don't think it is even required to capture buildings here. Might be. I usually, if you defend, it's easier experience against the AI as attacking. So I guess a German campaign might be somewhat easier if you're looking for the hard mode play, at least. Because attacking in this game really takes some consideration, otherwise you might get yourself killed. So if you're new, perhaps you want to start out on the defending side, which in this case might be the Germans, and if you're a veteran or looking for a challenge, play the Allies, which is the attacking force usually. But it depends, you know. If you do a counter-attack, of course things change. But looks like those guys are not eager to commit here, or we lost. We see some corpses here, and this here a complete squad, or even more than a single squad got wasted. Some US soldiers even giving up. I'm not sure where they are running, but it's okay. Usually they go to your front, which I guess they're heading to those guys, and when they reach you, they are basically captured or taken out of the game. Morale is a big thing in this game. And it's on a tactical sense, after combat mission, it might be my most favorite game. Because it's always fun to play it. And because I nailed the formula, some stuff is a bit abstracted, like I said, indirect fire. You might even have aircraft or off-map artillery, which is also absolutely devastating. You don't need to have a fire observer or whatever. You simply call it in and kill. That might be a bit over the top. Sometimes it can, I heard it also from multiplayer, it can sometimes resolve in some sort of indirect fire battles, which yeah, is a bit over the top. I mean, indirect fire was of course absolutely lethal. If you check the historical casualty rates, it was definitely absolutely a problem. But as you witness, you can really lay down indirect fire here like a champion. Yeah, and you can use this interface, already have informations like in combat mission, what are those guys doing, how are these guys, in what condition, healthy, are they eating enough, are they drinking enough, everything is here, how many rounds do I have, absolute great interface, I like the detail, not many games covering it, and infantry combat is also, I mean, infantry is more prone here to die, I value games that pay respect to the infantry. Many of those war games are always tank heavy and infantry, which is not the truth. Which if you check historical accounts, looks like we have a good setup here, but it's of course also a really difficult situation here for the Allies. I mean, we have a really good setup. If I would be the US, I would have myself troubles to figure something out here. This hatch is here, but you would need to bring some good opposition here to challenge this position. But they're trying, our bazooka team is. Let's get those guys quickly on the flank. Otherwise, they might endanger the mortar. But I don't expect here the Allies to pull off some. I mean, I can get myself also in this building here. Coming. Hold the line, I need to handle something. Yeah, and those overlays here, those greens, you can also remove them. I like cover because the green means good cover. And outlines, ah, that's team info, okay, yeah. And outlines are, is command. LMG or MMG firing here from the hatches, not spotted. Let's lay. I mean, there is a bit, of course. I mean, we observed the fire. Not sure if this is. But yeah, let's lay down a mortar here immediately. I don't think that was a mortar, right? Yeah, it is absolutely crazy. Is this a mortar? Those guys instant kill, instant lying down. Yeah, that is absolutely over the top. They. Mortar team, can you lay down, please? Fire in. Okay, thank commander. We're already on it, but you don't know even the coordinates. It's fine. We can read your mind. But could be that this was something else. I don't know. It that was quite fast, even for close combat. There's some mortar. Yeah, they are firing. They have 50 rounds. 50 rounds, I guess, mortar. Four rounds mortar. And he's saving ammo. There's something similar like in combat mission. They won't go for bad shots if they're low on ammo. So, yeah. He's low on ammo and saving ammo. Not sure if you can override it. But usually they won't fire only on good hits. Yeah, he's firing. I guess if you order it second time, he will fire, as he does. Yeah, far too accurate. Fast and deadly indirect fire. Yeah, indirect fire is... Not sure why they sticked in the series to that. I mean, from the very beginning of Close Combat 2 up to the newest titles, indirect fire is absolutely super deadly in this series. But they stick to it, so it is fine. Indirect fire, of course, was in reality also very deadly, but that is a bit even too deadly. Yes, again saving ammo, but I guess you can override it by giving another order. However, it is not an ensured kill, as you see those... Yeah, that is absolutely super fast, man. I just hit the marker here, already impacted. And yeah, you can override it by issuing another fire order, and but it is not super killing. As you see, this machine gun is still operational. A mortar doesn't blast, it doesn't have a blast radius of 50 meters or something. And those guys are now out of ammo. Let's move them into a building. Grenadier there. Occupy this building. Yeah, the sounds are really good. The machine gun sounds, yeah, that is a chainsaw. I hate games that don't get the sounds right. But sometimes there's those games where the MG42 sounds like a 50 cal. I mean, if you get the if you get the MG42 or a 50 cal wrong, yeah, I mean, you absolutely failed. Yeah, but that is this MG42. They even don't use the MG3 sound. This is really a sound of an MG42, you can tell by the rate of fire. Because the MG42 has a higher rate of fire than a modern MG3. So they recorded even, because many games I witnessed in the gaming career are recording the MG3, which is still in use by modern forces. And there are people that think the MG3 is the same as MG42. No, it isn't. And there are some modifications to it, and they lower the rate of fire. There's a NATO Bremse, or whatever you want to call it, a rate of fire limiter to it. But that is the rate of fire of a MG42. Way higher. But I like the firefights take quite a long. It looks quite authentic. Normally those guys get wasted at each other quite quick, but here it looks quite authentic right now. This machine gun is also not some sort of killing everything, but you see those guys are not moving. If an MG42 is firing on you, you're not moving. Those guys are absolutely pinned and might be in absolutely bad psychological state. The allies occupied a building here. I could move more to the windows, but that's what the Grenadier here do, is quite authentic. You never stick to a window, you always fire. Open warfare, you are trained to fire indirect. You are in the depth of the room and fire from there if you can. What you see in those movies or in those games where people stick to the windows, that is the most stupid thing you can do. You will get shot. No, you stick in the depth of the building and fire from out, inside of out. And those guys really handle it well. And can myself move up? No, not needed. We already engaging. Could move up the infantry gun here. Let's see how fast it moves. Oh, they move fast. Let's check the ammunition. The MG42. 1200 rounds, okay. Yeah, gift him some. In John Tiller games, I don't get more than 5 kills shooting at a 400-man formation. When I achieve the assault status with infantry, I'm elated. It's so right. As Panzer Command, it is specifically small landscape played last night. Yeah, many of those small-scale mortars were more, or those tactical mortars were meant more for suppression. Those 8 centimeter, but 8 centimeter is quite formidable. But for example, 6 centimeter or 60 millimeter mortars were rather not for killing, but for suppressing. There are even reports I read where the mortar impacted right beside somebody and they lived without. Yeah, this guy is absolutely. Normally, the MG42 would be overheated like madness. But perhaps he's changing the barrels. But still, you normally don't. I mean, what he does good is what you also see often wrong in those movies or games is that they fire the machine gun like crazy. People even think machine guns are inaccurate. No, it isn't. Machine guns are some of the most accurate small arms you can get. MG42 is firing like a laser. And you fire short bursts, and those short bursts, especially on a B or tripod, fire like lasers. You, on your own, need to add some sway in order to get some good coverage. Because those weapons are like lasers. Yeah, it's okay, MG42. Hey, it's okay, let's set this guy to ambush. Because then he will only engage close range, because this guy is absolutely burning through the ammunition, like it's way too high rate of fire. Let us come closer. I don't know what he's firing at. Those guys absolutely wasted here. Those two guys, yeah, but I think the Panzer Grenadiers will handle them. Let's keep the machine gun in reserve. Ambush means I think they will fire below 50 meters or something. 40 or 50 meters they will open up, or 30 meters. Okay, we're getting the infantry gun ready, but it looks like those US forces won't. Oh, this looks a bit troubled here. Those guys are not in good fashion. Zugtrupp, come over. But yeah, usually you fire an MG in short bursts. There are even people that can fire without fire selector single burst. But not really required. Yeah, that was a bazooka, I guess. Because sometimes, somewhere I read a command, yeah, this, you use the machine gun wrong, you need to fire it full auto. Yeah, no, absolutely not. Stop talking if you have no clue. Rather chew than talk. Just because you saw a Rambo movie, no, you don't fire machine guns like crazy. Machine guns are precision weapons. Sure, you can achieve a high rate of fire with them, but you fire in close, in short bursts. that's what they were trained back then, that's what they are trained today. And machine guns, MG42 on a tripod can fire down 1,000 meters. Precision weapons. I don't know whoever designed this, said machine guns are unprecise weapons. That's somewhat a gaming myth. Sure, if you run around like in Counter-Strike with a machine gun and firing from hip, that might be different. However, you can fire MG42 from the hip if you hold it on a... Or MG3, I can't tell for the MG42, but the MG3 you can fire from the hip. Yeah, you can also fire it from fellow soldier's body. Just make sure that he is covering his ear. Otherwise you might grip his drums. But you can also fire it from the hip by holding the bipod or whatever. If you are not some sort of weak individual physically, you can do it and even achieve success up to 50 meters. Okay, those guys are coming up. What the heck are those guys moving around in the woods? Looks like the US is not giving up here. You can even fire it single-handedly, like Lambo did. It is possible, yeah, it is possible. It's not advisable, because you usually want to use your second hand for the bipod. There's no reason to hold the ammunition belt if everything is... I mean, it can lead to loading issues if the belt is hanging low, but usually the machine gun feeds well. If those bullets, those projectiles are put into it, but you can also fire it single-handedly. You know, you test out stuff. If you want to pull off, in which movie was it where Rambo shoots a complete warehouse? Was it Rambo 2 or Rambo 3? But yeah, I like it that they got the... For me it sounds, I can't be 100% sure, but for me it sounds like a true MG42 sound. Because in many games you have an MG3 sound. Which you can tell by rate of fire. Okay, let's move up to the windows here, sneak up. Looks like... I mean, we have US forces here. But I don't think they will pull off a Zugtrupp, come over. On the other hand, guard this opening here. And mortars stay back in the back of the building. And yeah, pull back the infantry gun. That is way too dangerous to getting flanked or whatever. Pull it back here. All in all, this is a very nice series of games. Yeah, definitely, definitely. Wait, can you give orders for a pause? I think so, wait. Pause button. Yeah, I think there is one. Good question, yeah. Ah, damn it. Yeah, that was the truth button. Yeah, Min or German victory. Yeah, if he would continue the play, but it is fine. It is fine. It's also about losses. I guess this play is a tactical control because they occupied some objectives, but they lost a ton while doing it. Yeah, I mean, they might capture this objective, but lost a lot of force. Look at this force morale, absolutely bad, and this will translate in the campaign. Yeah, but that's really a good question. Can you pause? I think you can. Yeah, I will check this and I will do another video of CC and then mention it. That is really a good point. There's a hotkey for... I mean, you can slow down a game to almost slog. But yeah, tactical pause would be, of course... It's not that often required in this game. You not often have this totally overload, like, I don't know, in a combat mission game when playing real time or whatever, where you could end up with an absolutely stress overload. Close combat is a quite patient and slow game. But yeah, I mean, I'm pretty sure it would be a great option to have, at least for single player. I never used it, yeah, but we will check it out. No, it's not a problem. I want to keep those showcase videos short, and I mean, it was a victory. If we would have wasted more US or LE soldiers, the victory would resolve, I guess, in a major one. We might recapture objectives, but it's fine. You see, you can play those battles fast-paced. I think Close Combat is really good at playing quickly, small-scale action in an authentic fashion. You have small OOBs, usually consisting of 4 to 12 units. So it is basically company action. And yeah, because in combat mission, it gets more and more rare that you get those smaller scale action. Everybody's going big as crazy. Battalions, regiments, even divisions. I sometimes miss those small scale action, yeah, this advanced squad leader style action. Not only from a time perspective, but it is also a pleasure to play because you will pay more attention to every single soldier as when you have a OOB of 200, 300, 400 guys. Where if somebody gets wasted, you will simply say, okay, it happens, yeah. Here are the credits. Okay, empty. Good, yeah, it's definitely a good game series. If it warrants the upgrade to the longest day from Normandy, is of course up to your choice. I don't like to give verdicts because they're always subjective. I rather show you the footage of the game and you decide for yourself. It seems like the operational campaign is different in this, but I can't remember. I don't memorize everything. Simply check the streams. Check Normandy and check this, and then you can tell. Yeah, I think I didn't talk about operations. Operations are mini campaigns. Or did we? Yeah, I can't remember. Whatever. Let's start one. And operations resolve around a limited location on the map. You don't have the operational experience. It's basically formation against formation. Sometimes you have one versus one formation. Sometimes you have two versus two or three versus two, whatever. And it is basically a series of battles. What will result in this, where two OOBs fight each other or two formations. Yeah, and the Germans will also come with stuff. Yeah, that is the OOB of this formation. That is your OOB. It's quite small. Okay, not bad. Yeah, looks like this is more challenging from the US side. Might be a walk in the park from the German side. What the heck? Ah, wait, that is the... we are the Germans. We are the Germans, yeah. So the Germans is a hard experience here. But I'm not sure. I always play the grand campaigns. Could be that you will receive reinforcements or whatever. But looks like the Germans bring little to the table by the... What the heck? Yeah, I can't tell, I don't know how this resolves, check it out, but looks like the Ellie's OOB is quite big. Yeah, check out a different of those mini campaigns, and let's see which CC game we will stream next.